because I want each and every one of you to make a difference. Say that again! Declaring blessings to one another. So please hold the hand of the person beside you and pronounce our blessing of empowerment. Be healed and make a difference in your life. Be restored and make a difference in others. Be loved and make a difference in the world. Give the Lord a big hand. Give Him the praise. Treasures. Why remain Catholic? And top three is entitled Family. Say that again.
Family.
Ladies of Feast SM Manila, make some noise! Ladies, can you please look at the handsome gentleman around you? Bow! And please. Our fellow Catholics are our kapamilya. They are our kapuso, our kapatid, our kapanalig. And so with one voice and as one family, let us pray our feast declaration of abundance. Today, I receive all of God's love for me. Today, I open myself to the unbounded, limitless, overflowing abundance of God's universe. Today, I open myself to God's blessing, healing, and miracles. Today, I open myself to God's word. Universal family of believers nourished by sacred scriptures. Please extend your hands on the word of God and let us glorify His word by singing. The word is a lamp unto our feet and a lamp unto And we shall read from the Gospel of St. Matthew, chapter 9, verses 10 to 12. All together, please. While Jesus was having dinner at Matthew's house, many tax collectors and sinners came and ate with him and his disciples. When the Pharisees saw this, they asked his disciples, "Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?" On hearing this, Jesus said, "It is not the healthy who need a doctor, but the sick." Feast SM Manila MD, please put your hands on your heart. And say this with me, I can be pasaway!
I can be pasaway.
Declare this. I can be Pabebe!
I can be Pabebe!
singing.
Thank God for the grace of the Eucharist.
Now, when you study the history of Christianity, pag-inaral niyo po ang kasaysayan ng Kristyanismo sa buong mundo, magmula ng panahon ni Jesus, you will learn and you will realize that the early church believed in the real presence of Christ in the Eucharist. Tayo mga Katoliko, naniniwala po tayo, no? That Jesus Christ is truly present in the Eucharist. Tama po ba?
Amen.
Tama po ba?
Amen.
That's right. That's what we believe in, tayong mga Katoliko. Pero, yung mga kapatid nating Protestants, yung mga Protestant brothers and sisters, they find it difficult to believe in the real presence of Jesus Christ in the Eucharist. Eh, nakakapagtaka yun. Nakakapagtaka. I find it hard to believe na nahihirapan silang maniwala because the Eucharist is purely biblical in origin. The Eucharist is purely biblical in basis, galing sa Bible, yung Eucharist. Eh, di ba yung mga kaibigan natin Protestante, Bible-believing Christians, in fact, may doktrina sila na Bible alone, kaya ako nabibirduhan, bakit hindi nila mag-grasp? Bakit hindi nila maintindihan yung Eucharist, yung turo tungkol sa Eucharistia, when in fact, it's purely biblical in origin. And I'll tell you, I'll show you, no? When you read the Gospel of St. John, chapter 6, verses 51 to 57, John, pinaliwanag ang Eucharist. Basahin nga po natin ang sabay-sabay itong unang bahagi ng John 6, 51 to 57. All together, please. I am the living bread that has come down from heaven. If anyone eat of this bread, he shall live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. The Jews, on that account, argued with one another, saying, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? In your first part. When the Jews heard this, when the Jews heard Jesus say this, nagulat sila. When the Jews heard this, they took it literally. Agad, which is good, because Jesus is literal too. Jesus was literally talking about his own flesh and blood as the bread that will give life to the world. Totoo naman, literal ang intindi ng mga Hudyo, pero nagulat sila. Hindi nila kineri. Hindi nila kinaya. And they were talking to each other. How can this man give us his own flesh to eat? Pakisigaw nga po, ew. Pakisigaw nga po, yuck. Bakit nang sinisigaw ng mga Hudyo, no? And when Jesus said, and the bread that I will give is my flesh, Jesus is actually talking about his own flesh and his own blood. Literally yun, ibibigay niya. That's what Jesus was talking about. No? And yung mga Protestant po nating kaibigan, sinasabi nila, oy, when Jesus talked about his flesh and blood, it was just a symbol for him. Symbol? Pakisigaw nga po, fellow Catholics, symbol ka dyan.
Symbol ka dyan.
Ano kasi mga bata? Palapakin naman yung mga bata. Dapat nag-dance din ang mga yes, mga salutin kanina. When the Jews, when the people heard what Jesus said, when they heard him, marami po nagsialis. Ay, sabi nila, malala na ito. Nabaliw na yata si Jesus. Marami po malis kasi hindi nila kinaya yung sinabi ni Jesus. And some of Jesus' followers also left him. Now, kung symbolism lang talaga ang sinasabi ni Jesus, edi sana sinabi na ni Jesus, hey followers, hey people, wag po kayong umalis. Di naman kayo mapiro. Symbol lang yung sinasabi ko. So kaya niyong tanggapin. Kung symbolism, sana yun ang sinabi ni Jesus. Pero anong sinabi ni Jesus? Let's read together again yung pagpapatuloy po ng Bible verse. All together. Jesus therefore said to them, amen, amen, I say to you, Unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you shall not have life in you. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood has life everlasting, and I will raise him up on the last day. Binawi ba ni Jesus yung sinabi niya? Uy, simple lang. Hindi! He reiterated, inulit niya. Again, I say to you, inulit niya, unless you eat my flesh, unless you drink my blood, no, you will not have everlasting life. So, hindi niya ni-refute. Hindi niya binawi. Hindi niya sinabing symbolism lang yon. And when the people heard this, di na talaga nila kinaya. Umalis na talaga. Lumayo na kay Jesus. Sabi ng mga tao nun, uwian na mga beshi. Kinalingan masyado nito eh. No? Gusto niya yata maging bampira tayo. Eats my flesh and drinks my blood. Ano gusto niya maging bampira tayo? Ano tayo? Hindi ko kayang paniwalaan yan. That's what they said. And so they left. No? Jesus was teaching the bread of life discourse. This bread of life teaching in a synagogue in Capernaum. Doon niya ito tinuturo. Ang tanong, when the people left him, napentuhan ba si Jesus? When the disciples, some of the disciples, some of the followers left him, di rin lang inaya eh. No, ano nila lang iilan kasama yung 12. The other disciples, iniwan siya, di nila kinaya. When they left Jesus, napentuhan ba siya? Tanungin niyo ako, was he? Oh, not at all. He was not affected. In fact, ito pa ulit ang sinabi niya. Yung pagpapatuloy ng verse. Let's read together. For my flesh is food indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood abides in me, and I in him. Hindi pa rin niya binabawi. Jesus was insisting the literal interpretation of what he was saying. Now, if the Eucharist is just a symbol, why was it so hard for the people then to accept it? If yung simple yan, ganda rin tanggapin. If it was just a symbol, why was it so hard for people to accept it? Ask me why! Because the Eucharist is not a symbol. When Jesus said, my flesh is food indeed, and my blood is drink indeed, he was very clear about it. It was the literal interpretation of what he said. No? And in the Last Supper, in the first Mass, in the last meal of Jesus with his apostles, Jesus was very clear. This bread is my body. This wine is my blood. Palakpakan naman natin ang Panginoon. So are you now convinced of the real presence of Christ in the Eucharist?
Amen.
Amen. Palakpakan niyo ulit ang Diyos. For the gift of the Eucharist, God is saving us with his own flesh and blood in the Eucharist. The next time we go to Mass, let's give due reverence and let's be grateful because we Catholics, we have the Mass. Now, Mr. Alan Hunt is a former megachurch Methodist pastor who has a doctorate degree in the New Testament and early church history from Yale University. Ang galing ng university doon. Meron silang Divinity School in Yale University in the U.S. And Mr. Hunt, no, Alan Hunt, no, revisited, reviewed, and reread the Bread of Life discourse that we just read a while ago. No, being a Bible scholar, with a doctorate in New Testament, church history, inaral niya ulit yung Bread of Life discourse, and eventually, while he was studying, he was convinced that indeed Jesus Christ was truly present in the Holy Eucharist. And in 2007, Alan Hunt converted to Catholicism. Okay. Now we go to another sacrament. No? It's the sacrament of confession. Sino po dito ang nagko-confess? Taas ang kamay! Sino nagko-confess at least once a year? Taas ang kamay! Alright. We should confess regularly. I will discuss the sacrament of confession because it is closely intertwined with the sacrament of the Holy Eucharist. No? With the most blessed sacrament of the Eucharist. We Catholics, we believe in the sacrament of confession because we believe in the Bible. And the Bible tells us to confess our sins. And when we confess our sins, God is always able and available to forgive us. That's why we believe in this sacrament. No? At alam po ninyo, Jesus Christ was the very first confessor. At ang kanyang mga confessional box doon ay yung bahay ni Matthew. No, yung bahay ni Zacchaeus, yung well of Jacob, because it is in these places that Jesus encountered the sinners, no? In these places, kinakausap ni Jesus yung mga makasalanan, prostitutes, tax collectors, no? Public officials, doon niya kinakausap sa house of Matthew, the house of Zacchaeus, the well of Jacob. At dapat kinakausap niya, ama, syempre, napoconfess na ng mga kasalanan niya, patawad na ni Jesus. That's the first confession. And Jesus is the first confessor. Alam niyo, when you think about it, confession is just like the Mass. Confession is Jesus hanging out with sinners like us again. Di ba ganun din ang Mass? The Mass is Jesus hanging out with sinners, with sinners like us. And that is great because we can hang out with Jesus. Malapit siya sa atin. Now, the church teaches us that we should only confess to the priest. No? Kahit ng ibang pamilya, no? Meron ba sa atin mga pasaway? Inamin natin kanina. Meron ba sa atin mga pabebe? Meron ba sa atin mga papampang? Ganyan naman sa pamilya, no? And our Father in Heaven, not just like any family, our Father is always willing to forgive us if we come to Him and repent. Now, as I said a while ago, tayo mga Katoliko, we should confess to a priest. Ask me why! Because, ganito talaga mga bata, may konting delay. We confess only to a priest because Jesus said so. No? In the Bible, in the Gospel of St. John, Jesus appeared to the apostles just before He ascended to heaven. And Jesus breathed the Holy Spirit to the apostles and He gave them the authority to forgive sins. Now, alam ko na marami namang mga pare ang mabait, mapagmahal, very kind and compassionate during confession. Tama po ba? Nag-confess na ba kayo? Please, SM Manila MD, have you encountered those wonderful confessors? That's great, palakpakan nyo, mga pare nyo. Pero, naka-encounter na ba kayo ng pare na sobra kayong pinagalitan? Ay, lang, di ba tapos yung kanina? Halos hindi ka na i-absolve. So, ay, talaga? Nagsalanan nyo naman. No? Halos gusto mo nang lamunin ang lupa nung nag-confess. I've encountered such priest once lang naman in my life. And mind you, minority naman yan ha. Konti-konti lang naman yan. That's why, brothers and sisters, we have to pray for our priests. We have to pray for our confessors so that they will be more like Jesus every day. O, pagdadasal niyo ba sila?
Yes.
Amen. Palakpakan natin ang Diyos. Now, I'd like to end the Treasures series, yung Why Remain Catholic, by making a summary of the entire history of the Catholic Church And I will use these beautiful models, yung barko, hindi yung mga nagbubuha. Ay, they're beautiful na rin. Palampakan nyo yung mga nagbubuha. I will use these beautiful models lovingly made and prepared by our servant from the Singles Mission, Dutch Poliedo. Dutch, tumayo ka dyan. Dutch, tayo ka naman. Palampakan nyo naman si Dutch. Ayun mo. Salihin nga mo yan. Ang galing-galing gumawa. Oh, okay.
Wow.
I will use these models to summarize the entire history of the Catholic Church. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Isip ba kayo?
Yeah.
Ang galing. We love those kids. Okay. God is our master shipbuilder. Agree?
Yes.
Alright. Yes. God is our master shipbuilder, and He built this ship called the Catholic Church. Anong tawag sa ship?
Catholic Church!
Amen. And the captain of this ship is Jesus. Sino ang captain?
Jesus!
Amen. Now, Jesus said, I have to hire a crew to man my ship, the Catholic Church. So, nag-hire si Jesus na, this story is from Father Mike Schmidt. Baka mapanood niyo sa Facebook Live, hindi ko siya nirecognize. This story is from Father Mike Schmidt. He's a blogger, no? A Catholic priest blogger from the US. He's great. You visit his website, search for him in Google. Mike Schmidt, S-C-H-M-I-T-Z. Okay, so this story is from him. Okay. So, God, Master Shipbuilder, built the ship called the Catholic Church. Jesus is the captain, and Jesus hired a crew to man the ship. Yung crew niya, these are the apostles. E sino ang mga descendants ng apostles? Cardinals, archbishops, bishops, priests. So, yun ang crew. Now, sabi ni Jesus, out of the crew, I will assign a first mate. Ang first mate na, sino ba dito ang mga seamen? Mga seaman, seawoman? Okay, so nag-assign si Jesus the captain ng first mate. Ang first mate na yun ay si St. Peter. Sino ang first mate?
St. Peter.
Amen. He is the first pope. He is the first mate of this ship. Now, sabi ni Jesus the captain and God the shipbuilder, oh, we have to equip the ship properly. This is not even a journey. The journey is long. We have to equip the ship properly with all the gadgets, all the equipment needed for the long trip, for the long journey. So, okay, let's do that. Sabi ni Jesus, nilagyan ang pinakamagaling na compass. Ang tawag sa compass, Holy Spirit. And naglagay ng magagandang mapa. Para hindi maliligaw yung ship.
Bible.
The map? Sacred Scriptures. At, kailangan may makakain, may maiinom yung sasakay sa ship. No? The food and water, the sacraments. Marami pang nilagay. Si God at si Jesus, the captain, dito sa ship. Sabi niya, okay, may equipment, may crew, gawa ng ship, ganda. Now, magkatawag na akong sasakay. Jesus invited passengers, the believers early on, to ride the ship. So, ang dami ng sumakay. Ready na ang ship na maglayag. Ay, maglayag ka rin. Thank you, Dutch. I love it. Okay, iuwi ko to for Layla. May pamanggit. Okay. But just before the ship set sail, sabi ni Jesus, hindi ako sasama. Hindi ako sasama ha, sa inyo. Because I have to go back to God, the shipbuilder. Isama na kami. But I will monitor you through radar, sabi ni Jesus. So, hindi ako sasama. My first mate, St. Peter, will take care of the journey. Okay, sige. Layag na tayo, sabi nila St. Peter the crew. Okay, and then he set sail. Okay, ang haba ng journey. Haba. Ang tagal, many years, many thousands of years, ang journey. So, during the journey, namatay yung first mate, okay. Pinalitan nila ng ibang first mate. Nag-agree yung mga crew na, okay, mag-voto tayo kung sino first mate. So, namamatay yung first mate, napapalitan. Namamatay yung ibang crew, napapalitan. Nanganganap, dumadami, napapalitan din yung mga passengers. Okay. Now, there were times when the first mate was bad. Di ba may mga anti-popes? Now, there were times when the first mate was bad. Okay. There were times, even up to now, when some of the crew were bad. Cardinals, archbishops, bishops, priests, there were times when the crew was bad. There were many times when the passengers were bad. But, itong ship, ang tibay. Hindi lumubog. Kahit bad yung first mate, bad yung crew, bad yung passenger. Hindi lumubog. Hindi rin siya na off course. It's still following the right course and destination, God's kingdom in heaven. Even if some of the people in the ship were bad, wala. Hindi napinag yung ship, diretso pa rin siya. Ang galing ng compass eh. Compass ko?
Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit, galing. Hindi napinag yung ship. Kahit ano pa nangyari. Now, there were times when some of the passengers and some of the crew said, I don't want to be in the ship anymore. Ang boring na nung ship. Ayoko na. Gagawa ako ng sarili kong boat. Sabi ng ibang passenger, ibang crew. Pero sabi ko mga kausap nila, ano gagamitin niyo? What will you use to make your boat? We are in the middle of the ocean. What will you use to build your boat? Sabi ng mga passengers, and they'll get something from the boat. Dito ko kukunin yung materyales para makagawa ako ng isa pang boat. At ganun, okay, fine, sabi nila. So, that's what the others did. Kumuha yung isa, kinuha lang niya yung compass, yung Holy Spirit. So, pinagdikit-dikit niya yung mga compass, nakabuo siya ng small boat. So, may small boat na ako, alis na ako sa boat, pumunta rin siya sa tubig. So, puro compass yung boat niya. Galing naman nila sa Holy Spirit, no? In the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Okay. So, sige, naglalayag din siya sa tabi ng big boat. Yung iba naman, ay, yung mapa na lang, gagamitin ko. Yung Bible lang. Sacred scriptures na gagamitin ko. Pag itikitikitin ko yung mapa, makakagawa din ako ng boat. Eh, nakagawa ka. Nung nakagawa na, nilaglag, binaba na yung boat sa tubig. Okay, naglayag din. Sige, so, galing niya sa mapa. Kasi yun ang ginamit niya eh. Yung iba naman, gagamitin ko yung evangelization na nandito sa boat. So, yun ang pinagkikit-kikit yung evangelization, nakabuo din ng isang small boat. Nilabas sa tubig, naglayan, no? Nakapalibot dito sa big boat. Yung iba, kung ano-ano na lang ang pinagtagpi galing sa boat. Pero yung iba sinabi, wala na yung Holy Spirit na yan, hindi ko na kailangan ng compass. Tapos yung iba sinabi, hindi naman magaling yung captain, si Jesus, wala yan. Hindi naman yung captain talaga, captain-captainan lang. So, nakagawa ka naman siya ng boat, na yun ang ginagamit niya, kung ano-anong parte lang ng big boat, pero, ang iba rin direction niya, nakaharap na siya doon na siya papunta. Now, when you look at the ocean now, when you look at the world now, you will see thousands of small boats. No? May mga nagsasabi, 33,000 daw yung denominations. Pero merong mga nag-refute. Sabihin ko lang natin, thousands. No? When you look at the ocean of our world now, there are thousands of small boats all around this big ship. Ano nga yung big ship?
Roman Catholic.
Ano?
Roman Catholic Church.
You will see so many small boats around the big ship now. Yung ibang mga small boats, ang labit dun sa big ship. No? So pareho din yung direksyon na tinatahak. Fine. Siguro makakarating din, no? Itong tatlong dito sa harap. Dahil ang labit din dito sa big boat, baka makarating din naman sa patutunguhan. But, there are some boats who are so far off from the original ship, but they are in danger na maligaw. They are in danger of going somewhere else na hindi yung patutunguhan ng big ship. No? These are those denominations na ibang-iba na ang doktrina. Ibang-iba na ang paniniwala. May mga boat na sinasabi nung gumawa, siya na yung captain. Siya na yung Diyos. Siya na si Jesus. Yun, may mga ibang boat sinasabi, hindi ko na kailangan ng compass. May mga ibang boat, pabaguhin ko yung mapa. I will change sacred scripture. Ay, naligaw na. Nakaharap na sa likod. Doon papunta yung ibang boat at itong main ship. That is the history of Christianity. Naintindihan niyo ba? Palakpakan niyo naman ang Panginoon. Now, we all know that Jesus is the captain of our ship, right?
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
That's right. And Jesus, we believe, is truly present in the Eucharist, the source and summit of Christian life. No? And we believe that Pope Francis is our first mate. Pope Francis is the vicar, the representative of Jesus Christ on earth. And we believe that the crew of this big ship called the Catholic Church are the cardinals, archbishops, bishops, and priests. Palakpakan naman natin ang ating Panginoon. Today, this ship is still on course towards the kingdom of God. Today, 2,000 years later, the ship is still on track towards the kingdom of God. And we now have 1.3 billion passengers. Palakpakan natin ang Catholic Church. You know why we have so many followers? Ask me why! Because Jesus prayed for us. Jesus prayed for each and every one of you that we may be one. No? Tanong ko sa inyo, BSS Manila, how many church or how many churches did Jesus build? Ilan?
Isa.
Ilan?
Isa.
That's right, isa lang. Jesus only built this church, this ship, the Catholic Church. That's why. That is the reason why he is praying for unity. That's why he is praying for church unity. Because he built only one church. No? And Jesus is praying for us to be united always in his church because he said to God the Father, then the world will know that you sent me and have loved them even as you have loved me. Brothers and sisters of Peace SM Manila MD, Jesus prayed for each and every one of you. Noong pa ba? Alam niya na. Kilala niya na kayo. Jesus prayed for all of us, so please stay in the Catholic Church. Brothers and sisters, stay in the Catholic Church and love your family. Feast Day sa Manila, love your family and make a difference. Palakpakan natin ang family. Pwede na po nating tanggalin itong mga models. Yan! Palakpakan niyo ulit! Well, Feast Day sa Manila, I would like to tell you that I will be in the U.S. for the next 3 Fridays. So, mamimiss ko po kayo. Ang tanong, mamimiss niyo ako?
Yes!
Thank you, Fishing. Thank you, but, no? Our kapamilya and kapuso feast builders from Feast Bay Area sa PICC will cover for me. Here in Peace as a
brother, Bob!
Brother Dinoy will cover for me next week. Woo! And then on October 13, Brother John Ben and Brother Oli will be here. On October. Parang kinikilig naman yung mga kawa. Yee! Okay lang. Pwede ba yung kinikilig? Yeah!